Dang it. That's some garbage. I'm good. Here's Harden. Mane trying to get open. And with that shot, the Cleveland lead is cut down to three on the bucket from James Harden. And with James Harden winning the MVP in 2018, Russell Westbrook in 2017, Kevin Durant in 2014. KD. You think a few what-ifs right now in Oklahoma City?
A few, but more than that, Kevin. I mean, probably tough for them all to win MVP playing on one team. A good shot at a different trophy, though, maybe.
Boom.
Hey, guys, that's a big swing right there. I mean, taking the steal and then turning it into two easy points on the dunk.
No telling how important that sequence could turn out to be.
Yeah, he picked up the ball clean. He has a sneaky court awareness that you have to be careful around. That time results in the steal.
And it's Korver in the corner. Good, the assist goes to Hill. And now an eight-point Cavalier lead.
Well, he should be playing this game with an apron on because he's cooking right now.
Exactly, boy.
Ball against Hill. Paul kicks to Harden. The Rockets again can't hit.
Well, he's gotten shots up, but they're not finding the rim. The squad's suffering because of it right now. A bit out of rhythm.
Rockets trail by eight. Gordon, the pass to Paul. And a miss there on the triple. Cleveland's gotten the three-pointer to fall to the tune of 50% here in the third quarter. They've made three of six. Left side, Korver. Puts up a three. Hands it from downtown. Korver's got 14 points here in the second half.
Yeah, this looks like a pre-game shoot-around with all the threes they're allowing.
And Harden wide open. He shoots. Sinks the three-pointer. Harden's got a pair of threes now here in the third for the Rockets.
Back at you. That's payback for the three on the other end.
A little mano-a-mano there. Entertaining, but you also want to keep your teammates involved.
Leaning on that three-point shot in the first half. Seeming like they're just getting away from it here in the second.
Oh, the shot's coming from the interior.
We've got 13 seconds left here in the third quarter. Korver gets a wide open look. His three-pointer's off the mark. 1 second left. No good. Shot missing. Well, through the quarter play, down double digits, it's maybe difficult.
Shot coming up.
And let's take now this moment to... Free-
Look, I'm controlling the whole team now.
For yourself, but creating for others as well.
And this is it. Glad to have you along for this fourth and final quarter. AI is out there with Kyle Korver. Then it's Thompson. Then there's Hill. And it's Harrison. In it, the shooting guard. That's the five.
Guys, I'd be mad.
No, it's Chris Paul.
Here, Smith has checked in.
We talk so much about rhythm from the field. How about a rhythm from the free throw line? That looks good.
Pass to Korver. Thompson with it. Another shot.
Dude.
And I think Chris Paul never comfortable with that ball down at label garbage. Break. He never played with another guard who could create, certainly on the level of Harden.
No doubt about it. I mean, Mo P, J.J. Redick, guys who were great shooters, but really more off the ball players. Chris needed to be that kind of a playmaker, but with Harden, he has someone just as gifted at creating baskets for himself.
Carmelo Anthony has checked in for Houston, and that one misses.
Oh, my takeover bar is about to go down.
And he's good on the second.
Try and at least get my dude one assist.
The Cavaliers leading by seven. Some nice passing by Cleveland here.
Shock, huh?
Down low and stolen by Chris.
That's dumb, retarded. All right, I'm no longer in takeover.
Ennis. Off target from 3-point range.
Yeah, just a solid job on the backboard. They are really controlling the inside. And the D has gotten a little bit laxed here, defending the triple.
Timeout called the Rockets. We've seen AI really making a difference here.
So far, he is just destroying their will. It feels like he can get any shot he wants once he crosses half court.
Don't y'all keep me out whole game, folks.
52 seconds left to play in the final quarter.
Oh, that's some garbage.
And so it's Harden bringing it up for the Houston Rockets. Giving up just 8 points in the fourth quarter.
How many steals? Oh, one. You not one steal led to a dunk.
Manet trying to get open. Fouled on the shot and picks up 2 points. So one free throw coming up.
No.
And then just one or two shots at the end.
Yep, everybody standing up.
Catching up on the changes for Houston. Clint Capella, he's checked in for Ennis. Anthony comes in for Gerald.
That's some garbage.
Paul subbed in for Eric Gordon. You can probably expect to see him slow it down now.
Yeah, I think you want to milk
your possession. That's the first. Ooh, chill. 3-point lead.
Hell.
And the southpaw stroke of Harden is just beautiful.
No.
I can't. More lethal scores in our league.
PJ Tucker, he's checked in for Nene. And the Cavaliers call time here. They're down by four. 20 seconds left in the fourth. And now it's
presented
the game, James Harden.
It's a take charge brand of basketball he's been playing tonight. His point total tells you all you need to know about just how good he's been. And once
No, that's not cool at all.
Leads are not given, they are earned, playing with desire and attention to detail all night.
Timeout called the Cavaliers. They're behind by six. 15 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And so it's a narrow hit.
Bro!
They break the hearts of every fan in the building with a dramatic late victory.
That's not cool.
I mean, they battled with everything they had and came through when the pressure was at its
highest. GG, bro.
And that'll wrap it up, folks. So for David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, Brett Berry, and the whole 2K Sports crew.
I wanted to at least make 30 points, bro. 27.
You earned 0. 8.
Jesus.
You earned 23,000. Dang, you should get H1Z1. I can destroy you.
Ben Simmons. Well, sure. Can you use it? I'll let you know. Aight.
What if they put you on a different team?
That is not happening.
Guys,
we go on a win-win, lose-lose, and then win-win, lose-lose.
You're gonna lose that one. Is there one we go against the Cavaliers?
Why do we have back-to-back? Like, dude, that's retarded. I mean, look. We play the Heat. We play the Heat. We play the Pelicans. We play the Pelicans. The Bulls, and then we play the Bulls. The Wizards. And then you play the All-Star game is here.
And then what happens February?
Do my endorsements.
Father,
oh. $100 for player at a game. Buzzer beaters.
Sports pregame show.
Hello.
The Keurig K-Cafe Grill lets you easily.
Yeah, but I'll watch that later. One of the first pull off. God, did you say it? I don't know. Jump. Can't hit a freaking step back. Step back with the sauce. Step back with the sauce. And Dr. Dre said. Sizek. Is he a new guy? Hold on, are these guys actually on?
How is that dude a starter?
Checked in for Decker. Korver comes in for Jetty Osman. And AI subbed in for Jordan Clarkson. Minnesota also making some changes. Taj Gibson's checked in for Šarić. And Derrick Rose is subbed in for Jeff T. So on the floor for Minnesota, Gibson plays the four with Towns in the middle. Rose is out there with Andrew Wiggins. And it's Covington in at the three slot. Certain guys just make it look effortless. And Clark, I'm sure you would have a nice list of some of the smoother operators, smoothest scorers in the league now.
Yeah, there's only one guy at the top of it for me. I mean, I love a lot of guys, and there are a number of guys that put up big numbers. But when you talk about uniqueness, size, agility, touch, range, KD is where it stops.
Yeah.
I mean, there's just nobody quite like him. George Gervin comes to mind because of
Kobe Bryant. No, I'm kidding. Yeah, I'm gonna change this to a different color. Let's go with black.
Build, but the Iceman was 6'7", maybe 6'8". KD is pushing 7 feet tall and just a tad more athletic. I mean, I just don't know if we've got a more lethal, smoother scorer than him.
Lock at six. Here's Rose. And he can extend the lead to double digits. The Minnesota Timberwolves come into this one following a loss to the Bulls.
Yeah, nowhere near at their best throughout the course of that.
Yeah, no, I can't really see that one. Fill up shot meter. Let's go with magenta.
Game, a scrappy performance, but in the end, just not enough.
Yeah, a lot of character on display, a lot of guts. You're right. Even as shaky as they were, I would guess they felt they let one get away from them.
Korver.
There we go. That works.
And he's not going to miss that sort of an opportunity from deep.
And so it's Rose bringing it up for Minnesota. Right.
Still got some cyan in it. No, bro.
Well, last season, the Wolves ended a 14-year playoff drought. It was the longest in the association. And they did it in dramatic fashion. A winner-take-all overtime victory in the final game of the season against the Nuggets. I actually watched that game, and it was worth staying up late for.
And the Timberwolves making a change here. Jones has checked in. Here's Korver for three, and another three for Cleveland.
You know, the defense was lax right there, and he's able to make them pay.
Timberwolves leading by five.
Once my dude gets on fire, it's hard to stop him.
There's 39 seconds left to play in the first quarter.
It takes a little while. I mean, two out of six. It took four shots for me to shoot. Well, I got
fourth rebound in this one.
I heated up.
And the foul on Derrick Rose. That's his first foul. J.R. Smith's checked in for Cleveland. Kicks it to Korver. Shoots the three. It's good. The assist time from Smith.
Look at that.
And that's now 9 points for AI.
And gets off of the bench and kind of hot. But then shoots a few shots and then gets the feel for it.
Rose against Smith.
Hey, yo, what you doing, dude?
And here's Rose. Over Smith.
Yep.
And so, both teams trading buckets as we end the first quarter.
And the first quarter. Don't y'all sub me out either. Howard
scores in the game. Carl Anthony.
You know, everyone has to get some of the sugar.
Now, when you're attracting, Greg, all that defensive attention, it creates opportunities for your teammates.
And Towns wants to win big. To do that, though, it's not enough to get numbers. You've got to make
your
teammates better as well.
Man, I just ruined the,
And getting going again here in the second quarter. Fairly close game so far. And guys, what's your
Now heat streak is after you make four in a row.
On that offensive glass, that's led to a number of second chance points.
And we know energy and effort go hand in hand, and they won't be
denied. No, that's a heat check. My bad. Heat streak is going up.
In a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. On the court for Minnesota,
We've got Anthony Tolliver. Come on, bro. There with Jones. That's Taj Gibson. That's garbage. Nah. Nah, bro. That ain't cool. Remarkable for his basketball talent, but how he's giving back to his native country of Senegal. I mean, nope. We talk about unselfishness all the time in the basketball sense, but whoops. This is really whoops. Unselfishness in the greatest and truest sense. And Cleveland making a change here. Thompson's checked in, and with that shot, the Minnesota leads come down to just 2 points with the bucket from Korver. Minnesota's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. Oh, man. And finished off by Jang. The most natural ball handler now. But Jang does get up to momentum quickly on the drive.
He passed the ball to me this year. All right, now.
That's a two from Korver. Good, and Hill picking up the assist.
Knocks it down, boy.
Three assists tonight. And you mentioned the philanthropy of Jang. It goes way beyond running a basketball camp or cutting a check.
Yeah, he owns over 100 acres in Senegal, where he tutors local farmers. I mean, he's got a real passion for farming. Maybe more significantly, his contributions to hospitals in that poverty-stricken region, literally, literally changing and saving lives.
The Cavaliers have gone 2-4 shooting the ball here in the second. Here's Korver for three. Another three for Cleveland.
And they're getting their points down almost exclusively from the triple. Four of their last five makes are from beyond the arc.
And Greg, it's hard for me to watch this. I mean, the defense practically giving them those shots.
Minnesota calls timeout. Mark, you were in Indiana after being
what do you want?
By the Pacers for a few seasons.
I ain't call you.
Guys you played with them.
Well, Herb Williams, a teammate of mine at Ohio State, really outstanding big guy, mobile, could shoot it, excellent.
That was freaking annoying, bro. Yo, I took the lead.
Well, you have scored in bunches tonight, and you're making it look easy, and it isn't. How are you doing that?
Team.
Well, you know, it only looks easy because my teammates making it look easy. You know, they've been doing some great work for me tonight, you know, setting me up with some terrific looks. So, the points might be mine, but, you know, I got to give them all the credit.
Group effort leads to good results so far. Kevin, back to you.
Thanks for the great interview, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of basketball. And happy you could join us. We've got two quarters left to go in regulation.
All right, man, a man.
Korver's checked in. And then for Minnesota, Jang, he's checked in for Šarić. Tolliver comes in for Robert Covington, and Tyus Jones subbed in for Wiggins.
That's dumb retarded.
Clearly fouled on that shot that time, the whistle blowing. And there's the foul against Cleveland. The Timberwolves have had two chances at the line already, making them both. Teams
shut up, Matthew.
Often pound the offensive glass clock. I think of the 84 Celtics, but now teams
I'm clearly not playing Fortnite.
Maybe two guys to the offensive boards.
I think a big part of it is transition defense is so important that teams now don't send as many people
dang
to the
it.
Offensive glass. But the flip side of that is if you get offensive rebounds, you get opportunities to score and you can thwart transition chances. So I tilt towards trying to get to the offensive glass as long as you've got a couple of guys that are really good at it.
Tristan Thompson is all right. Up there with Decker. Then there's
I'm passing the rock for a little
then
bit.
There's Sexton. And it's Korver and it's small forward. That's the five for Cleveland right now. Tolliver kicks to Towns. Misses the three.
And it's a plus five advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Korver with it. Picked up by Teague. Fires from deep. Korver missing again.
He's tried to get it going, but the shots simply have not been there. Nothing seems to be falling.
Here is Tolliver, guarded by Korver. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. That's on Sam Decker.
Wow. He got whacked on that, which shouldn't be much debate there.
Blatant contact. Straightforward call. Simple.
A different look now for Cleveland.
Korver comes in for Decker, and George Hill's subbed in for Sexton. Taj Gibson's checked in for the Timberwolves. Hose comes in for Jones. Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David.
That's dumb, dude. Like, why am I not making anything?
A fair amount of soul searching by the league's other contenders. There is incredible pressure to shake things up. Now, sometimes it can elevate a team, but we have often seen also can tear a team apart.
It can be fragile for sure, David. Thank you so much. And you look at Jeff Teague now with a decade in the league out of Wake Forest.
No, if you're not spamming me with stuff.
Yeah, I mean, he's an explosive slasher and really has grown as a playmaker. Not a star, but a quality starting
player. No, he's not.
Yes, he is. He's playing Gang Beast. Unless he just got off.
Well.
I thought he didn't play that, or neither did Blazers. So, I was going to see if he could get
out. Rose kicks to Jeff.
I never see it. On your count, I never see Blazers.
Shot clock at five.
Either,
here's Rose.
Sometimes block off.
And once again, off the mark by Minnesota.
Well, you see the struggles he's having getting anything to go.
Yeah, I'm sure he's frustrated, Greg, because nothing is falling right now. But he's going to keep chipping away at it, and that's the attitude. Stay with it.
Passes it to Jang. Inside. And he makes no mistake on the slam dunk.
Gorgui Jang doing a nice job getting the ball to the open teammate there. Nicely done.
And stolen by Jang. Got a piece of it. Outside Hill. This one for three, and he sinks it from deep. Three-pointer good from Korver. Korver's got 22.
And that's another three. And if the defense is hoping that they don't heat up from out here like they did in the first half.
13 feet away. The Cavaliers pull it in. Thompson's got 4 rebounds in this game. Korver gets a wide open look. Korver missing again.
I wonder if switching baskets really threw him off. I mean, because he can't get anything to fall this half.
Wiggins, and Wiggins throws it down.
I started to itch.
Always admirable in a basketball player, and Covington consistent at giving it up when one of his teammates is open.
And these are the types of games where one...
What the heck, bro?
Tonight, it will be a win by a large margin for the Cavaliers.
Looking at both these teams, they're great rebounders, and on any given night, you might not know who would have the advantage on the board.
They made the most of those extra rebounds as well, Kevin.
And they took charge when it counted, and they'll be notching their 9th win overall.
No doubt they came in very motivated to win this one and finish the season series at a game apiece.
Absolutely. I mean, they had this date circled on the calendar for redemption. I mean, you never want to lose 2 games and be swept. It can be harder in an East-West game than playing against teams in your own conference, so this is a big win for him.
And what a tremendous standout performance it was for AI.
Every time he shot it, it seemed like it was going to drop in. And if it didn't, everyone was surprised.
Unloads. They get it again. Nice shot by Thompson.
Yeah, I knew that was bad. Shouldn't have shot that.
And giving the fans what they came to see, a spirited performance.
Well, they've got to be pleased with the effort they've seen so far tonight. Everybody pitching in for what looks to be a solid W.
And here's Korver from the arc.
Why? Dude.
Wiggins right side over Sexton. Can't connect from 14 feet out. So we see the Cavaliers taking the win here.
Why couldn't I not make anything towards the end?
Under control for the vast majority of the game, and whenever there was a misstep, they just didn't allow it to fester.
Wait, I filled the takeover meter.
Sports post-game show.
And we welcome you back. I'm Ernie Johnson. We got Shaq here. We got Kenny here. With this one in the books, we've got a special...
Hey, this is Shaq. Hurrah! You've been beasting these last few games, and it's fun to watch. Anything you feel you've done differently to make this impact?
You know, Shaq, sometimes adrenaline takes over and I just decide it's time to go out there and put on a show. You know, I'm a man of the people, and the people won't win, so that's what I'm gonna give them.
You're not a man, you're an animal. Roar!
And thank you for tuning in to the NBA on 2K Sports. For Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, Kevin Harlan, and the entire 2K.
Thanks, man.
Nope. All of shot and color. No. Oh. Check out A. That's how you do it, dude. No. Oh, dang. Just by getting 99 overall, you get a custom 2K shoes and a copy. Oh, that is cool. Everybody gonna be in here right now. Pacers, 76ers, the Hornets, and the Jazz. Alright guys, DMC Life, signing off. Hope you guys enjoyed the video of the NBA 2K19. Guys, leave a like, comment, and subscribe. You also check out Golden Jays on his YouTube channel. Alright, peace out guys, DMC Life, signing off.